Praise the Lord. I have a scripture that I want us to take in the book of Ephesians, chapter number 1, verse number 3. It's very important. It's on the subject of blessing. Verse number 3 says, "Blessed and worthy of praise be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessings in heavenly realm in Christ." What a wonderful scripture. The scripture is in my heart, and I love the scripture so much because it talks about the blessing of the Lord. The Bible says the blessings of the Lord makes rich, and the important part is it adds no sorrow. Because it's possible that you may be rich, you may be comfortable in life, you may have all the money that you have, but with no joy, with no comfort. But the Bible talks about here the blessing of the Lord. And many people are in search of the blessing. Yeah, many people are in search of a blessing. Everybody's looking to be blessed. Everybody's trying everything only to be blessed. But I like this because the Bible does not talk about the blessing which is in future, but it's talking about the blessing that is already commanded unto us. The Bible says, "Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus." In other words, we are not about to be blessed. He has blessed us. And that is very much important because that makes you to be comfortable and content, knowing for sure that I'm blessed. Now, the blessing is not necessarily the material thing. It's not necessarily what you can grab, what you can touch. But the blessing is more spiritual than it is physical. But what you can touch can be a result of a blessing which is on top of your life. Now, if you are a blessed person, you can produce something material, something that is visible, something that you can touch. But the actual thing is a blessing within that you have. Now, the Bible says you are blessed with every spiritual blessing. Now, many people may have a difficulty in taking this thing, that it's a spiritual blessing. Now, I need a physical blessing because I live in the physical world. Now, God must bless me physically. Now, I'm here to tell you this. Whatever the Bible says, whatever that is physical is temporal. But what is spiritual is permanent. When God chose to bless us in the spiritual realm, He chose a permanent place. In other words, when a physical thing runs off or runs out, you are not desperate because you know that you carry a blessing from within. And if you carry a blessing from within, even if the natural or the physical thing can be taken away, you can rebuild it, you can redo it, you can reproduce it, because the blessing is not external, but from within, internal. It's a blessing of the Lord. And when you're blessed of the Lord, nothing can curse you, nothing can stand before you. Many people are running around trying to be blessed and trying to be comfortable or confirm the blessing of the Lord. You don't need to run around. Where you are, where you're sitting, you can know this in your heart that I'm blessed of the Lord. Now, if you go out of this place and go to your place, wherever you're working, wherever you're pursuing, whatever you're pursuing, you can do it knowing that I am blessed of the Lord. Now, if the blessing of the Lord is on top of me, whatever that I do shall multiply. Whatever that I try to do will happen in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm here just to tell you that in the name of Jesus, you are blessed, for God has blessed you with all spiritual blessings. Now, it is your responsibility to convert the spiritual blessings into a physical substance. How do you do that? You first believe that you are blessed. Now, when you do and you go to get whatever that you need, you go with motive and courage, knowing it, I've already got it. Now, to do what you have inside is easy than believing something you don't even know it exists. Now, the blessing is already there. Then when you go to do anything, it will come to pass. May God bless you. Love you all.